I think we're ready to party.
Yeah. Snake Man's gonna kick his ass.
Oh my god.
What's going on, guys? So we did a lot of work on the minivan yesterday. Don't think it was quite enough to make a full video out of it, so we're just gonna do a quick recap of what we did yesterday. So we got the blow-off valve welded onto the intercooler piping. We got the new map sensor on. As you can see, we have a up pipe on the turbo right here. This is the one off the hatch that we're gonna be running just so we can get it tuned. We got the wide band on. We ran both gauges into the car. Let me think. We took the hood off, obviously, so that's just gonna be temporary. We will do a down pipe that goes, you know, down and under the motor. I just wanna have this set up just for now so we can get it tuned. We got the alternator on. We did have to cut the bracket to get that to fit, which is right here. That took a minute to sawzall through. Big chunk of metal. But we got through that, got the alternator on, ready to go. We still need clamps. We need to pick up an O-ring for the blow-off valve because we lost the one that it came with. And then right now I'm getting ready to plug the laptop in because we need to change some things on the tune, because also last night we got the new injectors put in as well, the 2200s. We had to go pick up some top hats from Brent yesterday, so we were waiting for parts and we did get it done. So we met up with him, got the top hats.
I got the road, man. I got the stuff.
Yeah, make it smooth. Got the injectors in. We also got a drain done for the turbo, so that's all ready to go. All the oil stuff is done. It has oil in the motor. We have a new oil filter, and it's pretty much ready to be fired up once we adjust the tune. So I'm gonna pull up my laptop and open up the tune. We need to change the injector size on the tune and also change the map sensor, and I guess we'll see if she fires up. It also does have a full tank of gas, which is, you know, just 85 or 91. I don't know what I put in it, but we're gonna have to drain that at some point today so we can swap it over to E85 if we do put it on the dyno. We also put my distributor off of the hatch on there because the eBay one, we couldn't get the timing to quite line up, so we're gonna try the distributor off my hatch just for right now, see if that was the problem. But yeah, as long as everything goes smooth today, we are going to try to put it on the dyno, and I guess we'll see where we go. If there's any problems, then I guess we gotta fix them, but I would like to see it lay down some power today, so we'll see what happens.
All right, so we're on the Hondata right now. Gonna change the current injector size to 2200 cc's. And then we also need to go to this button over here for the map sensor. Right now it has it selected as a stock map sensor. We need to go to replacement map sensor. And then the one we have is a 4-bar, which is down here. That guy. And then, let me think, I think that's all we changed really for the tune, or all we need to change. Let's upload that real quick. And I guess we'll see if it fires up.
Hardware real quick because we need an O-ring for the blow-off valve because we lost the one it came with. So if we can make it that far, then I think we'll be alright.
Well, the minivan made it to Ace Hardware. Just had to stop by real quick so we could get a O-ring for this blow-off valve, so we have to take that off real quick. Hopefully they have the right size. But yeah, it's not leaking anything, so that's a good sign. And then after we get that O-ring, we're gonna head over to PFI.
That one's too small. This one should work. Guess we'll see when we get it on the van. Try this one out. How much was that?
Looks like that will work. Gotta make sure it doesn't come off when we put the blow-off valve on. All right, I think she's ready to go. Off to Brent's, off to PFI. Get her tuned.
So we made it to PFI. It is now dark out. We've been messing with the van for a while now. So it was running really rough because it turns out one of the injectors wasn't firing. It was like stuck shut or something. So we got the injector replaced and Brent has been messing with the tune. It's running really good right now. So we're ready to put it on the dyno. But before we do that, we need to drain all of the 91 out of it and put the E85 in there. So we got about 3 gallons that we filled up right over here before we left. And we did have the return disconnected, and then we had that going into a jug, but that was taking forever. And then we decided to back it up over the dyno. This is actually Todd's idea, and take off one of the dyno plates so I can get down in there, crawl down right through here, and then we can take off the bolt that's on the bottom of the pan so we can drain it and then get all the gas out of there, and then we can start filling it with the 85, get her on the dyno and get her tuned. So I'm gonna climb down there real quick and get the plug off, and then we'll be able to fill her up with E85.
So I'm in the dyno pit right now. There's the drain plug. Figured I'd show you guys what it looks like down here. It's pretty cool. Here's the rollers for the dyno. So that's pretty sweet. But yeah, I'm just gonna pull this plug off right there and then drain it into this gas can right here.
Definitely a first for me though. I feel kind of claustrophobic under here. He's almost out, dude. It's about time, dude. This thing's getting so heavy. My eyes are burning. I'm getting like gas fumes in my face right now. It's almost out. I don't know how it's still running. Look at that.
How you feel, Kyle?
I feel like shit. Dude, that was so heavy. I was getting so tired. Alright. Pull her forward. Get me out of this hole. That was horrible. Got it.
Imagine being down there while the dyno's running.
I never realized those were so deep.
Like, that's pretty far down there. Yeah, dude, that would be so terrifying to be down there while the dyno is going.
Yeah.
Those rollers are so much bigger than I thought.
We got the van on the dyno. We just got the ignition timing set. So we are borrowing the distributor off of the hatch. The ignition timing was perfect. So that means the eBay distributor that we have needs to be replaced. So something was wrong with that one, but this one is working good. The timing's all good to go. She has the 85. So Brent's just messing with the tune right now, getting a base map set up, and then we're gonna start doing some pulls and see what she makes. Also, I did just look up the wastegate spring with the wastegate that I bought from eBay. And it says that it has a 14 PSI spring in there, and that should be plenty for the power I want to make for right now. And there's no sort of boost controller, so it's just going straight off the wastegate spring, and that's what is going to control the boost. So we can't turn it up or turn it down. It's going to make what the gate is set to. So I guess we'll see how much she makes.
Yeah.
She's getting there.
So the minivan just put down 387 horsepower, but guess the fuel pump is going out on us. So we're gonna try to pull the seats out and get the fuel pump replaced. I guess we're gonna try to throw a 450 in there, see if it'll fit, because it was a struggle to get the 255 in there.
We'll make it.
But Brent's confident we'll make the 450 fit. So we're gonna get the seats out and try to change the fuel pump real quick. Yeah, I did just find this fuel pump laying around.
God.
Hey, but it works.
Usually, sometimes when it's just laying in the shop, it's not.
It's probably not good. Yeah. There's probably a reason it's not being used.
Yeah.
God damn, this does suck, dickhole.
Dude, I told you it sucked. I'll be surprised if we can make the 450 work. I couldn't even get that in there.
Oh, it needs more floor cut.
You need more. Grab them chin snips.
There's no bag.
There's probably down in the tank somewhere.
There's not?
No.
Well, that's probably drifting around in there, because I feel like it had a bag when I put it on.
Putting fuel pump, race fuel pumps in a minivan. What? Thank you, whoever cut the access.
Yeah. Thanks, previous owner, for the access hole.
Some guys at home going, that's my van.
Hey, that's my van.
You were right. You made it fit.
Made it fit. I bled. So we know it's all good.
$318.
443. Holy crap. So close to 500. Holy crap. Yo!
567, bro.
He's gonna jump
so sweet.
Now.
That's so awesome.
It's so sick, dude.
Oh! Oh! Dude! The crank pulley came off.
I saw that.
Shit.
Didn't hurt anything.
No? Is it good?
Is the keyway still good?
The keyway's hanging off the crank.
It needs a new keyway.
Well, no, but did it break the crank of the keyway?
Yeah, did it break the slot?
Oh, no, the key's still there.
Dude.
Oh,
what the hell?
Look on your face, right?
The look on your face,
dude. I thought it was just done.
Hold on. This face.
I was really worried.
Yeah, we'll get a bolt and a keyway and just put it back together.
Whoops.
My God.
Dude, I didn't know what was happening.
Like, no, not that belt. The alternator belt.
Oh yeah, where's the belt?
Somewhere.
It's gone. Dude, that would work.
Oh, the caliper?
Yeah, caliper. Caliper.
Caliper hits?
Just that one
That's
piece.
That's just a grinder away. You put that whole ear off there.
Yeah.
Imagine the minivan rolling on some slicks.
Yeah. I think that's gonna
That's gonna happen.
You me? That's awesome.
Oh, you find a keyway? Yes. So we got a keyway. So what happened was, I guess I didn't get the crank pulley bolt tight enough. I hit it with my impact as best I could, but I guess that wasn't enough. So now I learned my lesson. You need to put Loctite on the crank pulley bolt. But luckily it did not damage anything. So we got really lucky there.
Yeah, good thing
and
we were just playing with the two-step, right?
Yeah, we were just playing with the two-step. Yeah. Good thing it wasn't on a pool or out on the street. But thankfully, Shane let me use his crank pulley off his H22 since he's replacing it anyway. So we'll be able to throw this one on and hopefully we'll be good to go. It also turns out my axle nut was really loose too. It just like fell
really
off.
Really loose, it wasn't even on.
It wasn't even on. The hubcap was just, it was just rattling around in the hubcap. So I need to get a new impact.
Yeah.
That impact does not work at all.
This takes a beast.
I'm just glad it didn't hurt nothing. But, dude, it made 567. Freaking crazy.
Oh, yeah.
Put some big old, like, 275 out. Radials on the front. With some skinnies on the back.
It'd be so
and a
sweet.
Parachute.
It's gonna happen.
And go roll the streets.
Look at that, dude. It doesn't even stick out.
Dude, and this is the biggest offset on these wheels. This is 5.5. We can do
a 4.5.
4.5 and it'd be perfect.
4.5 would be perfect.
They're the same price. These are
with
cheap wheels.
With the 275 radial.
Exactly. I'll show you the link for these tonight.
That'd be so sweet.
I'll show you the link for these. They're cheap. They're $106 right. A piece.
I'm down.
They're $106.
Get it ready for the track next year.
Oh, dude, yeah. Roll around on these.
Roll
on.
Well, everything.
Yeah.
Well, I want to keep some sleeper hubcaps though, you know? So maybe we can like
sleeper hubcap for it.
Just do that. There we go.
Make that
there we go.
Screw to it.
Oh, dude.
Yes.
Oh my God. That's sick, bro.
It fits perfect.
Oh, man.
That's awesome. Oh, yeah, we got that.
We got all the room in the wheel in the back. Dude.
Yeah, all the room in the back.
So 4.5 back.
So sweet.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah, that one's kind of loose.
Yeah.
Let's see what's behind door number two.
I'm guessing it's another axle nut. Oh, no. It's just loose.
It's just about to fall off, but it hasn't yet.
Now, did you have your notch in that one?
No. Well, lesson learned. Make sure everything is tight.
So in the process of the crank pulley flying off, it ripped the alternator belt in half. But we're still gonna run it. It's just missing a couple ribs. But it'll be fine.
What do you mean?
We got the crank pulley all tightened down. Should be good to go.
It'll
so
be fine.
We got lucky. Yeah, we got real lucky. It'll be fine though.
It'll be fine.
I told you guys it'd be fine. All right, go for it.
Are you ready to test it?
I'm ready.
All right, here we go.
Fired up. Moment of truth.
I think we're ready to party. Yeah, this minivan's gonna kick some ass.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Hey, Busy Moto, don't come out and play with the real f***ing Odyssey.
So bad.
All the tires on.
Yeah, does it, and it just like sits all the way back, doesn't it?
It feels like a boat. It's like rocking everywhere.
Yeah. What about you towing it? Let the tires scrub it out.
Holy shit! Holy shit! All the way down the street.
Oh, look at this one.
Holy shit! Here, look, it goes from there all the way up to there.
I think you've done something.
I think we broke the internet. We did something awesome.
We did something awesome.
We just need to get some more shots of it during the day.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
This is one hell of a lawnmower.
Yeah.
The smoke's still coming out the inside.
All right, well, thanks, man, for the awesome tune.
Thanks, brother. I love it.
It turned out great.
Yeah, it's so good.
She's way faster than she was before.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Well guys, we made it back home in the minivan. So she put down 567 to the wheels, which was a little bit more than I was expecting. So we did end up changing the fuel pump while we were there because whichever one I had in there was bad. So it does have a Walboro 450 now, has the same exact setup pretty much now as the hatch, almost identical. We definitely need to get a 4-port boost solenoid for this thing and wire in the boost by gear or the boost control into the Hondata so that we can do quick spool. It'll help the power ramp in a lot faster, and then we can do boost by gear because right now this thing is just blowing the tires off. It's like not going anywhere, but it's also really sick at the same time. But yeah, we made it back. I'm really happy with the power it made. Sorry if the video was, kind of dark. I did want to film this during the day, but I had school earlier and I just wanted to get it done. So we did plan on putting it on the dyno today. So we just went ahead and did it. We'll definitely get some more daytime shots of it here pretty soon. But there's still a lot more we need to do. I still want to take the up pipe back off, and I want to run the down pipe actually down and not straight up so I can put the hood back on. And we need to put the bumper on and then also run a dump for the gate. And then there's a couple other little things here and there, but it's getting there. But yeah, I'm really happy with where it's at right now. And got pretty late. We had a lot of problems with the car. We finally got everything figured out. It's running good. So yeah, that's gonna be it for tonight, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. It's probably gonna be a long one, but yeah, cause we did a lot of stuff from yesterday that I'm gonna throw into this video, so. It's whatever. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And as always, thanks for watching.